Sitecore, Azure AD Authentication, and Multifactor Authentication. So about myself, my name is Pratik Wasnik. I have 3 years of experience in Sitecore, and I'm working as a senior software engineer in tech aspect. So this is something, this is the POC which I worked on for the first time. So I might be needing some, suggestion or something. If you have, please share, or if you have any suggestion also, please let me know about it. Okay, so quickly just take out the topics. The topics which we are going to cover is what is OAuth, then what are the points required for Azure AD and policies, what is multi-factor authentication, what is process flow of OAuth, after that Sitecore changes explanation, so the changes we need to do in CMS as well as in our custom patch up file. So the last one is the demo, so I am going to give a demo on how we can just create one user in Azure AD using authentication, OpenID also. Okay, so what is OAuth? OAuth stands for Open Authorization. So as its description says, it is the open standard for token-based authentication and authorization on the internet. So OAuth is pronounced, as OAuth, and it allows user account information to be used to third-party services such as Facebook, Google, Microsoft. So you don't need to create a user in Sitecore. So what it does that it creates virtual user in Sitecore. Virtual user is something that is a non-persistent user, so it is not permanent. You won't be finding that user in Sitecore's user manager. That will be present only in the Azure AD. It won't be present in Sitecore. That is the virtual user. We'll see how we can get it. Now, what are the advantages of OAuth? The first one is you can use the same login for web as well as native, that is the mobile apps. The second is that you don't have to save the session, because as soon as session is over, the information will be lost. Then you can easily set expiry date in the token itself. And the fourth one is the simplicity. If we use Azure AD, most of you might be knowing about Azure AD. So we can easily create the users and managing user data, authenticating, signing up, signing in is relatively easy using that. Let us see the next topic. Yeah. So points required for Azure AD and policies. So Azure AD will have to create Active Directory, application sign-up signing policies from the same application. And there are two types of applications in Azure AD. One is the B2B type, the other one is the B2C type. So in this demo, we'll go with B2C type and we'll see how to create, how the applications are created, how the directories created, what are the policies, because Azure AD gives us some inbuilt policies, so we don't need to customize those policies. We can just use their existing functionalities, features to save time, and as I said, it comes with simplicity. So we'll cover that, how, what are the properties, features we are requiring for that policies. And as the third point in policies, adding the setting as per the requirement. Let us look at the next slide. Okay, so this is the process flow of OAuth. So this is the crux of this demo, we can say. So as you can see, whenever user hits the page, whenever the request comes from web application, so the first thing is that from Azure from AD, what we'll do that we'll first verify that the application is actually registered there. Then we'll create token, and then we will make post request predefined with some URL and authorization token. That token will be passed back to web application, and from there web application will receive it, and then it will call to get keys from that AD. So the keys request will be sent from web application back to Azure AD. From Azure AD, that is application, it will fetch keys according to the defined policies. Now, as I said, defined policies will vary as per requirement. In this case, we have used four claims. I will show you later. So according to the defined policy, those public keys, they will be transmitted back. And the final step is to validate that token using a predefined format. So that format is predefined. We have to use that format only. That only we need to make sure. After that, when the token is valid, then virtual user loads the receive claims into profile. And here we can do additional thing also. We can log that customer into Sitecore also. But in this demo, there was no need for that because it is a simple B2C end user. This demo is designed from the perspective of getting extranet anonymous user, which is a end user, we can say. Now let us see next topic. Okay, so Sitecore changes to be done. So what we'll do is we'll create a patchup file and add entries related with Azure policies and endpoints in that file. After that, we'll add a custom processors in the same file, and then we'll set login page in that file. In the same patchup file, we'll set login page, and then we'll add a required login for the restricted item. In IIS binding, we need to make sure that we will add additional binding for that website, and it has to be with HTTPS. If we add it with the normal HTTP 80 port, then it won't be working. So that is one thing we will just need to make sure. Okay, so just let me show you. Sorry, a mistake, I think. Let me start the PPT again. Yeah, coming to the slide where we will see. So let us see these points again. In Azure Active Directory, we need to create, Active Directory, then application, then the policies. So let us see how can we create them. Now Azure has two different portals. This is portal.azure.com, which is the upgraded or the newer version of the portal, and there is another old portal. You can see that also. Yeah, so this is the old portal and this is the newer portal. Get load. Okay, so here we can see this is Azure, and the active directories which are created, they will be listed here. So by default, the user login, that domain will be given here by default, and this is AD which is created for this demo. So if you want to see the policies related with it, so what we can do here is that we'll have to go here, then we'll see B2C. So this is the application which we have created here. So this is the application. So domain name, we can give any domain name here. Then this is the tenant type, production scale tenant. As I said before, there are two types, B2C and B2B. For this repo, we have used B2C. So if we go for the applications, here we have one application ID, we will be using that. We can add different applications also, but only one application is needed for this demo. So if we want, we can add different applications as per the requirement. Now let us see what details are present in this. Okay, so if we open this, so we can see that the application ID is there. Then there are options to include web API or not. So we will be using web API, hence we are choosing it as yes. Then allow implicit flow also as yes. Then here we have to give reply URL. Now I have created two pages, home pages and demo pages. Now whenever we see an e-commerce site, there are some pages we can be accessible, which are accessible for normal user, but there are some pages or the secure pages or the restricted pages which are accessible only when the user is logged in, right? For example, checkout pages. So checkout pages are accessible only when the shopping in shopping cart some item is added and then user is logged. Otherwise, it will be redirected back to the home page. So basically, that is this URL, reply URL. And native client, we don't need a native client for that. So for this demo, we won't be needing that. So it is selected as no. Now, if we go back here, if we go back in the policies, we can see here B2C my policy. So we can give the name for the policy. Here, this is the metadata endpoint. So if I click on this, then it will basically give the metadata of this application and these policies. So all these settings will be needing in our code to authenticate and authorize. Primarily, this URL is very important because it will be dealing with the claims. Then this is the token endpoint. And this is the authorization endpoint. Also, we can see that there are response types, scope supported. So we are using OpenID here. Then subject type supported pairwise, ID tokens and email values, token point authentication method supported. So the claim supported here are the family name, given name. Now let us see what are the claims here. So in this policy, metadata endpoint is there and runtime endpoint is there. So now let us see. If we select the same policy and if we try to edit, here we'll see the attributes, the features which will vary according to requirement. Now for this demo, we'll be using only display name, email name, given name, surname. So these features, these text boxes will be there when the user will try to sign up. When the end user will try to access the restricted page, he will be thrown back to the sign up page by policy. So Azure AD gives us inbuilt policies. We don't need to create any page. We don't need to create any text box, nothing. Everything Azure AD will give, we'll just need to give the authentication claims and then it will be redirected back. Yes. So here if you see, here we can see this run now endpoint. So if you are able to see it, so in this endpoint there are multiple sections are there, or the things are there, like if you can see here, the policy name is there, then client ID is there, then bounce value is also there, redirect URL, which is we have given here, we can edit it. So all those things are here, ID type and everything. So what the application will be using is that first it will see whether the user is logged in or not using a simple API, Sitecore API, whether user is authenticated or not. So what we can have is that we can have the API liberties Sitecore can provide, and at the time we can have the benefits of using existing policies of Azure AD, so that we will have to, you know, work very little, and then we can have the benefits of both the system. Yeah, so let me go back again to okay, so these are the signup attributes. So these text boxes we will be seeing when an unauthorized user is trying to access restricted site, restricted page. After that, these are the application claims which will be requiring, you know, code. Same given email addresses, given name, identity provider, and surname. Also, multi-factor authentication. So what is multi-factor authentication? I think most of you must be knowing, but if anyone can tell? Yes, correct. Correct. So you all have heard that there were cases of email getting hacked, of Yahoo account, of Gmail account. Yahoo had also emailed its users that their account was getting hacked. So basically, to restrict that, to make web applications as secure as possible, what nowadays what we are doing, what web applications are doing, is that they are providing this OTP feature. Everything we are purchasing now is related with OTP. So when we try to purchase something, it is either giving us SMS, it is or it is either giving that code or something in email. So this is called as multi-factor authentication. And Azure's benefit, simple. We just have to use this on and off. That's it. So we have chosen is that on. So this is overall Azure AD. What? Yeah, please go.
B2C, I think this is okay, multi-factor.
B2B,
how do you ensure that it's
multi-factor
authentication?
Well, so what we can do there is that internally in the code for B2B, even for B2B, if the user has to be logged in, if it is authentication, then he has to be logged in, right? If he has to be logged in, then obviously he'll have to provide email. So in that way, in B2B case, what we'll do that instead of giving him SMS, we'll just customize our code and then we'll give him email, so that the required information will be given in email instead of SMS. Yeah, because if user has to be logged in, then obviously his email ID, some of his unique identity has to be required for any application. So that thing we can target, we can just customize the code and then we can proceed. Okay, now we have seen the AD features. Now let us see Sitecore changes. Yeah, so here we can see again, I'm reminding again. So we have to create a patch-up file, then we have to add custom processors, then set login page property there, and then we have to add require login for the restricted item, and in IIS binding, we have to add HTTPS protocol only. Now let us see what these things are in practice. Let us go to our CMS. And let us log in with our favorite admin B. Okay, so let us go with admin B. Right. So as I said, there are two pages here. One is home, which is accessible to every user, and the other one is demo, which is accessible only to the logged in user. So let us see what are the changes we have given as per the slide. Okay, so these are demo, and then this is the normal home. So if we go to demo, and if we go to the security page of it, so what we need to do is that we need to give require login here in demo. Okay. So now we have given the require login here. So now let us see what are the things we have to do in Visual Studio. Okay, so this is the patcher file we have to create. These are the changes we need to do. So first one is that we have to add all the entries here, which is nothing but this metadata entry. So these entry we have to add here in the patcher file, then using Sitecore configuration settings.get setting or any application manager, we can just get these settings. The second thing is that, as we have said, required login for that item, we have to set here set login also. Now this is a nothing but a controller method, so we'll see that method in a while. And these are the pipelines which are required, so these are the custom processors inside the pipelines, HTTP request begin and pre-process request. So this is nothing but user resolval class and user initialize metadata class we'll be needing to use. So first I will show you how the demo works, and then I will show you that what are the code which are used for this process. Okay, so let us go for the demo now. Okay, so So I had already logged in, so because of that we were able to see that restricted page, but if we try to log in now, then it will be redirect back to this. So this is the authentication which we did here. We can, if we are already logged in, we can simply log in and then see. Otherwise what we can do, that we can sign up here. So let us see the sign up. So these are the claims which we had given here. These are the sign up attributes. So the sign up attributes which we selected will be shown here. So let me just give one sign up user. receive the code. Okay, and we can set some password. Now we have a user manager similar section here also, so using which we can see that what are the users which are there present here in AD. If we see, if we go in that section, user and groups, we need to go to all user. Here we can see that what are the users which are which have signed up using the policies. Now this user Mohan Bhargav, it is a fictional name, it is actually the name of Shah Rukh Khan in Swadesh. So yeah, so this user was created directly from here. So if we add user here, so here the domain will be sitecoreid.onmicrosoft.com. But if we create the user, if we sign up the user from this form, then that will be having the domain name as per the email address given. So this is the difference between the types of user here. So once we add this user, as you can see, there is no test demo user here. Once we add this user, I will receive an SMS. Check the given correct number. This is new SIM. Actually, I gave the wrong number, sorry. This was the new SIM, actually, I didn't know the number. So let me just cancel it. One more. Oh, basically, to save time, what we'll do that, we'll just keep this part because already some time has been lost. So we'll just go ahead with one user which is already present there. Follow the same approach for everything. I mean, if all the users have to be treated equally, if we don't have to give them, you know, some personalization or some additional benefits, some liberty, something like that, then we can go ahead with the same. For that, we can use application also. In this demo, instead of session, application we have used because it will be same for all the users. But if we need to give some benefits, then we can use sessions, or we can simply unblock from the application. We can unblock that from a user from application, so we can follow that approach also.
Yes.
having the number of accounts. It's a similar way.
So now I will receive for sure. Yeah, so here we go. So this is the restricted page, demo page requiring login. So if we yes.
So if I want to dynamically
do redirection? Simply URL FFR you can refer, you can do from context. From context.
So when exactly I
will get the control from the pattern, I will show you that. I will show the code also. So basically this was the flow, this was the demo. Without it you it would have been very difficult to understand the code at all. So that's why I showed you demo first. So this is the restricted page. So after logging in only we are able to see it. And this is the other home page. So home page obviously we will be able to access. Now we can use the Sitecore's API signout for functionality also. So simply the authentication manager signout function, only the action link is given to you. We'll see that also. So simply this using sign out. So now we have signed out and now we won't be able to access demo. If you try to access, it will again redirect back to this thing, to ID. Now let us see what is the code used for that. So basically first is this patcher file changes we need to make. Then here, the very first thing is that this initialized metadata. Now let's look what is this initialized metadata. So it will call one method called as initialize B2C helper initialize metadata. Now if we go to B2C helper, so these are the app IDs, these are the redirect URL. So one thing is we can have it from patcher file. But for some reason, while accessing on code, I was not able to get the exact value, so that's why I had to hard code it. So here, these are the same value which we are getting from the patcher file. So once we get this patcher file, what we are doing is that we are first checking whether the application has some data. If the user is logged in, then this application will be having some data. If not, it will be null. So accordingly, it will move ahead. Now this is the format I was talking about, this metadata endpoint. So this is the login.microsoft.com. And we just need to replace some values with the tenant name. So tenant name is nothing but the application ID. And this domain is by default, Microsoft has given this domain, but we don't need to change it. So this is the tenant type, application ID, and this is the policy name which we have given. So after that, we'll simply give the get type of method request, then we'll get the response. From response, we'll get the serialization done, and then finally we'll assign back the values in this application. Now, as we see this flow, so as you can see this flow, so the last part was getting claim from Azure AD back into web application and then creating the virtual user. So this function, this keys wrapper, that does it. So what it does, that it gets the data from the application we just had given assigned values. From here, using the same get request, it will get the keys, it will deserialize the keys, it will get the keys, and it will give that keys back to application ID or web application. Then finally we'll create the user. So here you can see the simple line of codes we are using. Virtual user using the authenticator manager, we are building this user, and then we are giving the properties as per selected in the application claims. After that we are saving the profile and we are giving is virtual true, And the benefit of that the user won't be added to Sitecore's user manager, but it will be created only in the Active Directory. So that's how we create a virtual user. And these are the methods which are used for validating the token and all. So here, for some public and private network CNN, you might be knowing about it. So according to that, the different policies and different sections are divided here. And then we are just returning back if the token is validated or not. And if it is validated, we are returning as true. So this is the main coding of that. And for logout only, simple authentication manager logout we have used. So if we see here, we had said login page here. So this Sitecore B2C authorization sign up. So what it does that it So here, coming to your question, so we can use this URL referrer also, but I had given demo here. So just need to check whether the user is authenticated, context user. That is the benefit of, we can use the API benefits, Sitecore API benefits, and we can use, the ready-made policies of AD also, Azure AD also. And then we can simply go to initiate customer sign up, which we just saw. And this way, finally, using WebUtility redirect, we can redirect back to home. So that is regarding the code. So any questions about this?
Basically, redirection to Azure portal, that difference in that last line of initialize statement?
No, it happens. Let me show you. Here. So what it does is that this metadata, we had set application, right? So from that application, we'll just cut these settings, these properties, we'll just get these properties, and then these properties, we'll just append it in the string filter, and then we'll pass out. So this is the final URL which is required for that policies. Obviously, according to the policy name and all, the features given, we will be giving these properties, scope, clients. So this is nothing but the same which we can see here. Scope, then response type. So everything we just need to pass it here, and then it will be redirected back to at sign up or the login page. So the policy is same. It's not different policy. Same policy is used for sign up. Same policy is used for sign up. Mm-hmm. Okay.
But I'm trying to log in. Mm-hmm. I'm authenticating,
so I can't
log in.
Okay.
So I cannot be able to select that particular page.
Okay.
Because I'm authenticating, but not supposed to be access that particular group of pages.
Mm-hmm. So for that what we can do is that for that we have to mention here what type of user type is that. In Azure AD, we have seen the users, right? So from that, we can see what type of user type is there. And then we can change, whether that person is authenticated or we just need to write one handler. So is authenticated API property what Sitecore does? So we have to just tamper it. What we'll have to do that we'll have to write one handler. In that handler, we'll have to give what user type is given, and then according to that, we can restrict him or allow him for that page.
So that is all from code end. That is from variant.
No.
So is it like something like depending on the roles, so groups, and
then you have to make any
variant.
Didn't get your question, sorry.
So basically, the based on the site based on the with a list of views.
Right.
So with a policy of meetup. So if you have to, as he is mentioning, I mean, you just start to the point. If you have more users, like I want to restrict at a group level, say, at a different, that comes to a different set of a rule based authentication.
Right.
So for that, in order to enable that via this Azure Active Directory, is it like you have to group your users into particular groups and then, you know, assign the pages or the how should we do it?
Well, I don't have much idea about that, but I think that the user group will be same. I mean, I'm not sure about grouping. If anyone has idea, they can suggest. Yeah, yeah, I mean,
group.
Right.
So you create a new page and you assign it to the finance group user.
Mm-hmm.
So that page accessible only for finance group of user.
Right.
But somebody is authenticated from another user, like another developer or somewhere, user is not. But that is authenticated from the different group.
Right.
So he's not able to access the page, but he's not the unauthenticated. He's an authenticated user.
Mm-hmm.
He will redirect to some another page.
So that is authorization.
Could be some home page. That could be a home page.
That is authorization. So whether he is authorized to see the page depends on our segregation.
Yes.
If he is authenticated means, you know, whether he is in our system or not, it checks and that happens. So authorization comes later. Authorization
yeah.
would be role based as well as, you know, group based.
Yeah, and about the creation of, you know, group-wise users in Azure ID, so I don't have much details about that. So if anyone has used Azure ID user group, then perhaps they can share something.
I guess in the Azure dashboard, we were able to see user and group. So maybe the facility is there only.
I think that opens up one more question that I want to put in through the community, like where you are around. So Sitecore basically is like a scalable CMS, right? So we have AWS as well as Azure AD. Azure is like, you know, Microsoft technology. So
right.
Has anyone had any experience on using both, like, or, you know, have you seen any like advantage, pros and cons between those two, like, and adapting as well, like, which is better, or, you know, which was highly scalable, or in which were developer friendly as well as, you know, maintenance.
I mean, from the user management point of view, or from the
application maintenance point of view, like deployment, need with the deployment, or, you know.
Well, I mean,
support.
Yeah, both have some pros and cons. I mean, Azure AD gives us you know, many ready-made features, many benefits which can use. We don't need to create for that. It also gives us some extra security also. But if we want to customize that, then it is a little difficult compared to the straightforward plain Sitecore logic, if we go with that. So that is totally depend on the requirement. I mean, there are some projects which already have users in ID and they want to continue with ID. So in that case, I think it is better to go with the Azure ID. We can ask client also in which, I mean.
Typically, in our developer cycle, we see one system is on AWS where they have our development, I mean, which has like auto scaling it.
Right.
And few of it you have Azure. So as a standard practice, which is, I just want to try to understand, you know, which could be weighed when we are weighing options or in adopting architecture level, which could be weighed better or which would serve purpose for one purpose or maybe we got to delve with that. This is an open question. If you guys have any experience on it.
There's a module available.
Sitecore is coming up with a lot of modules which is like ready made on SEO sailing, SEO search, which is like we can replace for UC or Solar or something like that. And then Cosmos DB is coming up for as a replacement for MongoDB.
Okay.
So by maybe like going further forward. Maybe Azure might be the best solution to it. Like, right now,
deploy
we use AWS for deploying on our. So more of like Microsoft and
Azure. Microsoft and Sitecore collaborating, building all these.
And as you
being
a Microsoft product, so they're pushing towards.
If you want to use Sitecore only with Azure AD, then as Anandita said, we already have module. For that, yeah. But here the authentication, I mean, we had to change the logic and all, and I had to show you, so that's why this demo is given. Otherwise, with that module also, the same thing can be happen, provided we need to customize something. But here, if we just, play with claims as we have played with tokens and claims, then we have to go through the, by the way, which I demoed.
It's good to understand native code, then we can say
yes. Okay, any more questions? Great, thank you.